It is now Kamala Harris versus Donald Trump.
Oof.
Joe Biden stepped down. He wasn't energizing the Democratic base. And since Kamala has stepped in, this chick literally in a week has raised somewhere near $400 million. Now, folks, some of y'all know me real deep, and y'all know I do have problems with all the money in politics. I do. And I'm disgusted when I see all this money that's being spent to try to sway politicians to favor rules to the way of the rich when the average person can't get things done the way they want it. We've got people homeless. We've got social programs that aren't helping people. Hell, we've got banks not giving people loans that could use it, that could uplift their businesses. So when I see that type of stuff, people, make no mistake, I'm frustrated. However, that's the way they play the game until we the people vote and get it out of the game. But she raised the most money in history. She's got all these people and caucuses whipped. And what do they do? What are they trying to do to what I consider to be the strongest organism ever created on God's green earth? African-American woman is the strongest creation, considering everything they've had to endure in America. She's going up against this guy, Donald Trump, who could care less about women, really. No more than what you can do for him. I could literally make the argument that's his whole relationship with people in general. Well, en route to having to deal with Trump, my crew, take a look at some of the gaffes and behaviors of Trump, and yet people still want to vote for him. Take a look at this.
Kamala Harris has a secret admirer. It's Donald Trump, who gave her $6,000 to run for Attorney General of California. Here's one check for $5,000. Guess who else gave Kamala Harris money to run? Ivanka Trump, Donald's daughter. Well, guys, you know, if Kamala Harris is good enough for Donald Trump, she's good enough for America.
President Trump, he made the commencement speech.
Oh, yeah.
And then it turned out it bore quite a strong resemblance to Elle's graduation speech.
Yeah.
In the New York.
Yeah, it did.
Yeah, was it Jimmy Fallon who found this out? I know it was all over the internet.
I don't know. Maybe it was on Jimmy's show.
If you haven't seen it, it's sort of unbelievable. We'll just show them the thing.
That we take our next steps into the world.
You must go forth into the world.
It is with passion.
Passion.
Courage of conviction.
Courage in your convictions.
And strong sense of self.
Be true to yourself.
We did it.
I did it.
Have you not seen that?
No.
I've never seen that. I always fall down YouTube rabbit holes, and I missed that completely.
It's true. He is better when he sticks to the script.
Do you know how that happened? Or is he just a fan of the film?
I'm sure he's just a big fan.
All right, Momo, you get first dibs on that. As we get ready to talk about what Kamala Harris and her strategy is going to be to win this White House, you've seen small snippets of what America remembers during Donald Trump's era. Monique, why is it that so many people are adamant that they want to vote for a convicted felon multiple times and go back to just having pure mental mania under the presidency of Donald Trump again?
Every time I see footage from January 6th, 2021, my stomach hurts and I get angry. Like, I was laughing, but with the Elwoods and all that stuff, him copying.
Right.
But then as soon as you put that clip up from January 6th, I just, if you could have seen my face, my whole demeanor changed. I don't have the answer to that because I ask myself that all the time. It's asinine. I don't know. I know how we got here, and he plays a good part in how we got here, but we've gone backwards, you guys, and I'm very scared. Like, I'm very scared. Like, years ago, this would have never have been acceptable, ever, ever. The fact that he played a part in January 6th and is still able to run for president,
mm-hmm,
is asinine, it's alarming, it's disturbing, it's questionable. I question everything about government. I mean, I always had an issue with government, obviously, but right now when you talk to other people from other countries, I feel like our government is just the credibility, whatever little credibility we had is really at the bottom of my shoe at this point. And I don't know how we get back from this, Lamont. I really don't know. When you get so low and in the gutter, right? What does it take for us to get out of this?
You want me to tell you what a lot of people are saying?
So far, but my thing is, it went so far, okay? Mm-hmm. That I just feel like when things go too far, I don't want to say never, but it's going to take a miracle to get it back. That's how I feel. Because he poisoned the system. He poisoned civilians. You know, I've lived in the South for quite some time, you guys. And I'm telling you, in what you guys already know, when he ran for president in 2016, it's like he evoked some type of thing. And the people who were racist and had this disgusting mindset, they just came out the woodworks and they became so bold. And mm-hmm, I've never seen that boldness. Even being in the South, there was still a level of decorum that people had, and that's gone.
Mm-hmm. Okay. How do you feel about Trump, Moochie? And
it's a level of decorum because people feel really threatened now. You gotta feel threatened if you gotta bring out this much hate.
Yeah, that's true.
You gotta be afraid if you bring out this much hate towards another person.
Mm-hmm.
And this is not the first time that Donald Trump has used a movie to use a speech. Check out, he used the bee movie, a movie with a bunch of bees.
What?
He used the bee speech.
I gotta look that up.
You think the people that follow you are stupid and they believe anything?
They are.
You can quote something from a Disney movie and Legally Blonde and think nobody knows where this speech came from. You know, you hear something like, damn, this sounds familiar.
No, but Moochie, the problem is he has blind followers. It's a cult following. Did y'all not see that bull crap?
But at the this, where they had the stuff like, come this on.
Let me get my
they had their ears.
They had them that believe that.
But this is how they had the gauze.
They had the fake paper gauze around their ears. I just could not believe my eyes.
And he telling me he got his ear shot off.
Oh, there was so much blood everywhere.
Yeah, the capsule that you burst when you went down underneath the podium and put that on your ear real quick.
Okay, now y'all. Now the FBI has came out and said that the bullet did graze his ear.
And that's cool. That's cool.
Right.
We still got a cult follower who looked
yeah,
like
yeah, I agree. Now my issue with Trump. It's to some of what both of you guys have said, but it's more so to what Monique said. She just didn't say it as explicit as I'm gonna say it.
Please.
The problem is he was able to peel the veil off people's blanket of courteousness and just reveal their outright misogyny, racism and hate toward women. That's what he did. In terms of the way the government apparatus is established, he didn't change that. He just went in there and just pulled the hell out of it. Just pulled every hair out of it the way it is. Like all these underwritten rules that people used to have, he just said, I'm not doing that. I'm not doing it. And it's wrong. And then when we get to the point where you need to stop him, he can't be stopped because we have to wait on the Republican Party to help defend the country. And they are too consumed with wanting power in order to do anything to stop him. And so that leads me to Kamala Harris and what she can do and what this setup is. You've got the multiple convicted felon versus a tough as nails, charismatic, smart as a whip prosecutor. And let's see what strategy they have been unveiling against the Trump campaign over the last couple of days. Take a look at this.
He sent it back to the states, to be fair.
Let's be very clear. He is proud of the fact that he demolished the national right to choose in this country, period. And also, as you know, the Republican Party continues to be interested in a national abortion ban.
Which he's disavowed completely.
Yeah, he's disavowed a lot of things. I don't believe him.
Because
he lies all the time.
You think that his pledge that he would not pass a national ban is one that...
It's one that's going to go down with most of the promises that he's made and broken. The false message of the RNC was that this is leading to an increase in crime.
Well,
and I think it's really important that we talk about crime.
Have been very high profile about people.
Of course,
there
are individual cases,
illegally,
but this is my
people
point.
People would still
right?
be alive.
Trying to make people think that crime is up when crime is down under Joe Biden and crime was up under Donald Trump. Now, I don't know how often that gets reported on this network. So if you're watching this at home, do yourself a favor and look up the data.
Well, we invite that.
Great. So if you look this up at home, you will know that crime went down under Biden and crime went up
Certain
under Trump.
Categories.
And I think the violent crime, for sure. So I think the really important thing to ask is, why would America want to go back to the higher crime that we experienced under Donald Trump?
Okay, but
unlike Republicans, right, who in Trump's personality cult will take a look at Donald Trump and say he's perfectly fine, even though he seemed unable to tell the difference between Nikki Haley and Nancy Pelosi, even though he's rambling about electrocuting sharks and Hannibal Lecter, even though he is clearly older and stranger than he was when America first got to know him. They say he's strong as an ox, leaps tall buildings in a single bound.
Well,
we don't have that kind of warped reality on our side.
Well,
on the contrary, the president confronted that reality in what must have been one of the most difficult decisions for an American president to make ever. And he did something that I don't think Donald Trump could even conceive of doing, which is putting his own interests aside for the country.
Well,
there is a national right to choose in this country, law of the land, for 50 years, which the vast majority of Americans believe was the right thing to do. But Donald Trump made a promise when he was a candidate, one of the few promises he actually kept, by the way. You know, he didn't keep his promise of 6% economic growth. He didn't keep his promise
to
drain the swamp.
Well, he did have a pandemic to deal with.
But even before the pandemic, America went into a manufacturing recession, which really hurt places like where I come from in the industrial Midwest. But anyway,
my point is,
he broke his promise for that kind of economic growth. He broke his promise to pass an infrastructure bill, right? He said he would do that. He failed to do it. The Biden-Harris administration got it done. He even broke his promise to that January 6th mob when he said, I will be at your side when you march down to the Capitol. But he actually did keep two promises. He kept his promise to destroy the right to choose in this country, and he kept his promise on tax cuts for the rich.
Ooh.
Yeah, Buttigieg was cooking. Now, I must kick this off with you, Moochie.
Yeah.
Two of the fundamental principles the Harris team is going to push that they're going to do. Giving women the right to choose, that's one major issue. Getting back to a point where we have some kind of control around the Supreme Court, because they have just lost their mind doing all this ridiculous stuff. And the other thing that she's going to be trying to do is help people understand that, as he said, Donald Trump did give these great tax cuts to the rich and handed down everybody else these like $1,400 checks, which is absolutely nothing. why certain tax increase on certain blankets of income help the country. What do you have to say as to what she is about to be trying to embark upon in making history and trying to help heal this country from the stuff that we've been through over the last, I'm gonna say, about 6 to 8 years?
I feel like we're in a situation again where we have to vote for the lesser of the two evils.
Isn't that always the situation?
It is the situation, but yeah. She has a checkered past as well.
Which they all do.
We already know she was a prosecutor, so certain things she did to when she was a prosecutor, it doesn't sit right with me. And I want to trust her, but it's really hard. But like I said, we in a catch-22 situation. I wish it was a person that wasn't in either party that we could put our trust in, because I don't trust neither of the two, because I feel like it's two sides of the... I feel like they're both set the same side of the coin. Right now, we have to look at whose policies is going to benefit us. And right now, everything that Trump is talking about has no benefits for Black people. They're trying to take us back to the time of Jim Crow, and he's gonna use the migrants where they want us to be fighting these migrants, and that's not what we're supposed to be doing. They're using the divide and conquer thing. They're already using race. Now they're gonna have these migrants, and they're saying, oh, they're taking your jobs and all of this other stuff. So I feel like we really need to look at the policies that they're pushing, and you have to vote for what benefits, what is really going to benefit us. And are they going to come through with their promises? Most of the time they don't. Trump ain't come through with nothing. He said he was going to build the wall and they was going to pay for it. It's incomplete. They climbing that wall. They walking in between the wall. Not even climbing it. So it's just like... he's saying all the good things. He had the audacity to tell some of the people that in the deep South that he was gonna bring back coal, and they believed him. So it's just like, you know, like I said, you gotta look at the policies that they're pushing and then decide who you gonna vote for. I'm not gonna say pick Democrat or Republican or anything like that. You have to look and see who's pushing what and what is going to really help this country and benefit this country. Does that make sense?
Oh, yeah, it makes sense. And I'll kick it to Monique like this to just follow up on some things Trump said here recently. He was giving some kind of speech telling people that after this, if they vote him in office, they won't have to worry about voting anymore.
Yeah, I saw
and
that.
I'm assuming some of that has to do with the dictatorial powers the Supreme Court has anointed upon Trump by basically saying a president can't be prosecuted for criminal acts.
Mm-hmm. That too. They're gonna let all of this that happened with this Sonia Massey case. That means they'll be able to walk up in people's house and take them out and be immune to it. No trouble at all.
My point, the thing that I'm giving to you, Monique Nicole, as Moochie is trying to be so ambivalent and tell you not how to vote, I'll say it like this: we have a history of what we're getting from Trump. And Trump moves in the way of a dictator. Absolutely. And if that's people like to be told what to do, you're voting for Trump. If people like to be controlled by a dictator, you're voting for Trump. If people like mass hysteria and people trying to overthrow government. Now, mind you, I want to see government change too. I do. But I don't want to see it overthrown by a bunch of people that already don't like Black folks in the first place and then have it replaced with them. I don't want to see government overthrown. But when you're voting for Trump, that's what you're voting for. And these are not innuendos. This is not me making stuff up. This is what has happened under his watch. Mm-hmm. Now, having said that, Monique, I give the floor to you.
I don't know what to say. There's so much to say, and it's just, you know, I share with you, Lamont, politics has become very heavy for me. I very much so still have PTSD from 2016 and the years that followed under Trump's reign. Some of the comments are disturbing to me. Listen, y'all, I'm voting for democracy. I mean, Lamont really said it perfectly. It's just, you know what you're getting with Trump and then some. And the things that he's trying to implement, even though a lot of them are probably going to be false promises. Like Mucci said, he promises a lot and don't be backing it up. But why would you, as a Black person, especially a Black man, want to vote for someone who does not care about you or your kind and is willingly and openly saying that he's going to give police immunity when you already see how we get treated? You already see how they kill us. You already see what happens to us, and you want to vote for someone who has that type of mindset, that dangerous mindset? So you think if it's you or your cousin or your homeboy, you think Trump gonna give you grace? So you as a Black man gonna go vote for him? You think if it happens to you, your son, your child, your cousin, your brother, your homeboy, if they get hemmed up by the cops and they get their head blown off, you think Trump gonna come save you?
Well, let me help you out with that, Monique Nicole, because I can give you the innuendo into not just Black men, but a lot of men that a Trump party brings.
But this is the thing, Lamont, and I don't mean to be rude, but I don't care about what white men think, because I know what white men think. I have an issue with Black men who follow that same dangerous mindset. A couple years ago, I sat in, this is when Chris Cuomo just got his show on the news, News Nation, whatever that show, whatever the station is called. And I went for a taping, okay? Call me naive before, maybe I was naive or living under a rock before. That night was the first night that it hit me how many Black men are for Trump. I was so shocked. I was privy to conversations with Black men in that room. It was every demographic, every age group, and they let us talk freely. They wanted, you know how these tapings are when they want to see the spectrum of what people think. And that was an eye opener for me. And that's why I don't mean to be rude and I don't mean to come from my Black brothers. I love y'all, but we got to call a spade a spade. I don't care what the white man think, because I know what the white man think. I have a problem with Black men who are being brainwashed into either voting for Trump or the percentage of Black men who say, I'm not voting for Trump, but I'm also not voting for Kamala. That is still dangerous to me.
Yeah. To not vote, I agree with you. It is dangerous to not vote.
Because you don't see the bigger picture. To me, if you say I'm not going to vote for either, you don't see the bigger picture then. And what we're really up against.
All right. So I'll let you have your say. The reason why a lot of Black men are falling right in line with white men and not voting and supporting Trump is because a couple of things. Number one, the Trump candidacy Project 2025 and Trump's own equivalent Project 47, which is the same damn shit, just same gravy warmed over, is because part of that agenda is putting women back in their fucking place. Yep. Women lead the nation in education. And right now, there are more Black women in this country that have more education than any other group. And when that happens,
you know why that is.
I mean, you don't have to tell me, but I know. And by doing that, a lot of the men have been displaced. And a lot of the men can't force women to do their bidding in the households anymore because they have choice. And so, yeah, men want to see women put back in their place, have to grovel at their feet and not have as many choices as they once had because they've gotten so much education. That's one thing that both the Black men and the white guys want. And you don't have to take me for an example. You can just go read Project 2025 and all the bull jive in there that's setting women back that also includes reproductive rights. And someone said that you can go to the states. Well, that's bull jive because you can't go to every state. There are states that's saying no to the shit. And people is having babies nationwide. That should be a federal law. They don't give me none of this states' rights shit because they tried to pull that with slavery. and saying it was a states' rights thing, but we fucked that shit up and said hell to the no. So that's why a lot of men are falling in line with Trump, Monique, and then they're trying to do it under the guise of the Bible. The Bible said the man should be the head of the household. Okay, great. But if it ain't no man in your household, who becomes the head of the household? That woman got to do it. And then if a man is fucking up his job as head of the household, the woman pull the bootstraps up. You don't just get the mantle handed back to you. You got to prove yourself. So now that's why a lot of people are going that route, Monique Nicole. But more importantly, I still land on, is people's pocketbook more important than the thing that they have been telling us to have pride in for so many years? Freedom, patriotism, and democracy. We've been told since we stick our head out of our mama's vaginal lips that this country is about freedom, democracy, and being a patriot above money and all that. But we knew that shit was a lie from the rich. We knew it. And this lie has infiltrated the GOP's fan base. I call them a fan base because that's what they act like. This is some funky reality show. So much so that they got them believing that all you need to do is let the rich do what they want to do. They're going to trickle down money to you, and you someday will reach this lofty place where we're at. It don't work like that, ladies and gentlemen. It doesn't work like that, ladies and gentlemen. So my point today in this conversation, if you really believe in freedom and democracy, why are you voting for Trump? He done showed you he's okay with an insurrection. He done showed you he's okay with getting dictatorial powers from the Supreme Court. And then the minute after he got that power, the next day, he's filing motions to get out of his criminal charges, which brings me to the fact he's a criminal, convicted, and you still voting for him. But yet, people who cross that border ain't convicted of shit. You're willing to say that they the problem with crime in America when y'all is about to try to vote a person that's got multiple felonies on his record into the White House. That's my closing argument. And we'll get on out of here with that.